Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Hey guys, this video is being sponsored by an amazing nonprofit campaign, Pets Add Life. This campaign is dedicated to promoting the positive role pets play in the health and well-being of people, families, and communities. Did you know that there are 84.6 million pet-owning homes in the United States? And of those, 60.2 million are dog-owning households. And of the dog-owning households, 32% own both dogs and cats. We are a nation of pet lovers. Now, in my own life, I've owned fish, and as a child, my family had cats. Right now, I have a dog, and I'm a big dog lover. In this video, I will outline 10 things that you as a responsible dog owner should know and do to keep your dog healthy and happy. Number 10, being a responsible dog owner, you should feed your dog the appropriate amount and the best quality dog food. Just like you, your dog is what it eats. Number 9, you should socialize your dog. Socializing your dog with people and other dogs will open up your dog's world, allowing him to go strange places without being fearful or unruly. A socialized dog could go to work with you, and that's a trending subject in the American workplace. 11% of current pet owners report that their workplace allows for pets. That's an increase from 8% in 2014. Number 8, as a responsible dog owner, you should allow your dog to travel. Whether it's a walk, run, or bike ride, dogs love to travel in identifiable home range. The familiar sights, sounds, and smells will go a long way in stimulating your dog both physically and mentally. Number 7, when traveling with your dog, always have them on a leash. A loud sound or small animal darting across your path could send your dog dashing into the middle of traffic or off into the woods. For your dog's own safety, always have your dog tethered when you're out walking in public. Number 6, you should train your dog in basic obedience. This will teach your dog your basic language as well as your rules and expectations for his behavior. Number 5, do not set your dog up for failure. No dog is perfect, they all have limitations. You should be aware of your dog's limitations and avoid putting him in situations where he is likely to fail. For example, I would never leave my dog hungry and alone in a house with a trash can full of table scraps. That is a recipe for disaster. Number 4, get your dog regular health checkups. No dog is going to tell you he has a tummy ache or a bad back. Only a good vet checkup can do that. So get your dog to the vet on a regular basis. I personally take my dog to the vet twice a year. Number 3, engage your dog's genetics. Every dog is genetically programmed to perform and enjoy certain activities. If you have a golden retriever, for example, and you're not out hunting ducks, go out in the backyard and play some fetch. If you have a bloodhound, play scent games. These activities will satisfy your dog's genetic itch. Number 2, make your dog a member of the family. Give your dog a physical place and space within the home. Dog beds and crates are great for doing this. Make him a member of the family, allowing him to participate in family activities. And make sure you're clear on how he is to interact with the family, your possessions, and other animals within the home. All right, and the number one thing you should do, love your dog. Create a physical, emotional, and spiritual bond with your dog. 80% of pet owners agree that owning a pet offers happiness and emotional support. Loving your dog the right way will mean your dog loving you back the right way and providing you with the bonus happiness and emotional support. I want to thank Pets Add Life for sponsoring this video, and I want to encourage you to check out their YouTube channel. In the description below is a link to get you to their channel. Head on over, check out some videos, hit the subscribe button. These guys are doing a great job promoting pet ownership.